I'm Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at what an unmanaged tenant is, how it gets created, and what do you do with it. This actually has come up a while back. I used to call this a shadow tenant, but it's an unmanaged tenant or an unmanaged directory with inside of Microsoft Entra ID. And the concept is that there is a self-service signup with Microsoft Fabric, Power BI, whatever, and that actually creates this Entra ID directory or tenant behind the scenes. Imagine a user that has never touched a Microsoft service before. You know what? Instead of all this talking, you know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. Okay, so like I said, I've got a user here that I'm going to enter my email address with, and this user has never touched a Microsoft service or property or anything like that. So not Microsoft 365, not Microsoft Intune, not Microsoft Purview, not Microsoft Fabric or Power BI or anything like that. And so this is their first time going into Microsoft. And so you can see they've got a Gmail account set up. And so let's go ahead and try to sign into Microsoft Fabric. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to detect that, look, I don't recognize you as a user, so we need to create Microsoft free. This is the self-service signup, meaning that this account doesn't exist with inside of Microsoft, and so we're going to create it for you, or Microsoft's going to create this for you with inside of that Entra ID tenant or directory. And all a tenant is that organization that represents you. So like, we have a tenant for Guy in a Cube. That's where all the users are, the groups are, that's where the licenses are. So that's what manages that organization. Think of it like a container for those items. And so what this is doing is it's going to create a user with inside of that tenant. And so what kind of email is this? It could be a personal email, but in this case, I got it from my organization. And this is what's triggering saying, okay, there's an existing tenant here, or there should be. So let's go ahead and hit next. So now it needs to verify my account. So I'll put in my phone number and then we'll verify that code. Then we need to create an account. So let's go ahead and give it some info. One thing I need to call out, and I will do a separate video on this, is the concept of a home region for your Microsoft Fabric. So this is where your data is stored by default. Think of an Azure data region or a Microsoft Azure data region. That's what I'm talking about in terms of a home region. And so I'll do a video on how that's selected. But in this case, country is a predominant piece of that. So in this case, I'm selecting United States. So this will mean that it's going to create not only my Entra ID tenant, but it's also going to register Microsoft Fabric with inside of a Azure data region within this country that I selected. All right. So let's go ahead and create my password. And then what it's going to do is send a validation code to the email that you provided. So that's why I have Gmail set up. And so this is the verification code that you need from Fabric. And we'll go ahead and hit next. All right, and that's done. So now we can go ahead and get started with Microsoft Fabric. It's going to create that account in the tenant, and it's assigning a Microsoft Fabric free license to that account, nothing else. You're not paying for anything as part of doing this, right? So I'm not paying for the Entra ID tenant. I'm not paying for Microsoft Fabric or anything yet at this point. I haven't given a credit card for anything. All right, so now we need to actually sign in. And you'll see here that we've got Microsoft Fabric. But one thing you'll notice here is it's only got Power BI. And this is because of the fact I'm not paying for a Fabric capacity and I haven't signed up for the Microsoft Fabric trial capacity. So let's go ahead and dismiss this. And what I can do at this point, I can come in here. We can see that we've got a free account. I'm signed in as part of this, and we can also go get the free trial. So let's go get the free trial for Microsoft Fabric. We'll activate that and we'll go back to the homepage. We will hit the landing page and we can go into Power BI. And now we can see all of the Fabric resources because I have a Fabric capacity available to me or Power BI premium capacity that enables the actual Fabric features, and Fabric is enabled by default. So we've gone through the self-service signup and we now have a tenant, but okay, what's going on here? Why did you use the word unmanaged? So there are no other users in this organization at this point. Now, if I go into the Microsoft 365 waffles, the only apps I see here are Power BI and admin. That will actually take me through to what is referred to as the admin takeover for the tenant itself. I'll do that in a different video, but really there's no way to manage the users. There's no declared admin for this organization. You have to go through that admin takeover as part of it. But at this point, other users in that organization can still go through the viral signup and they will be added into this tenant or organization, because now it exists inside of Microsoft. Now, what's interesting about this is it's technically also for Microsoft 365 as well as Azure itself. And so there's one organization for this domain. So if I go over to portal.office.com and we'll see, hey, welcome to Microsoft 365. That's great. But I don't have anything here, right? There's nothing I can do outside of going to the admin portal, right? So I don't have any licenses. I don't have any apps. I can't do anything until it's a managed tenant. But right now in this state with the self-service signup and the fact that it didn't exist in Microsoft, it's unmanaged at this point. So if you've gone through that experience, just know that that is where you are at in your journey with Microsoft Fabric. You can absolutely leverage Microsoft Fabric and you can take advantage of the Microsoft Fabric trial capacity. When you want to go purchase a capacity, you're going to have to get it to be a managed tenant to have any type of paid subscriptions or anything like that. So let me know in the comments, have you gone through this experience or like, did you struggle with it? Let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear it. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.